Hello students, welcome to the video lecture series of Project Management and Engineering Economics. So today we'll discuss our last topic of unit 4th, that is project crashing, or you can say network crashing. So how you will crash your network? As I have already mentioned in previous lectures, in lecture 2 or 3 I think, I have discussed about each and every terms of network crashing, that is different types of cost, okay, resource allocation, resource leveling, resource smoothing, time cost resource optimization, then time cost trade-off. So these topics I have already discussed you in previous lectures. So before understanding this topic, just have a look on previous topic, that is time cost trade-off and all that topics. So it is very essential to study these topics before studying our latest topic. So here I am starting our next topic, that is network crashing. So first of all, I'll give you brief introduction about network crashing. So what is network crashing? What is the meaning of network crashing? And what are the requirements of network crashing? Why you are crashing your network? What is the necessity of network crashing? So I have already discussed that the effect of project constraints such as equipment, manpower and time. Okay. So the effect of these things will leads to project crashing. So in this section we shall be studying the impact of another constraint, that is time and other resources. Previously we have discussed for equipment, manpower and time as well, but in this, cost and time are the two important factors, two important elements in network crashing. So what is crashing of network? Network crashing means the effect of expediting your project activities on its cost. Means if you let us take an example. If you want to complete your project before the estimated time, means the estimated time is of 30 days and now you have to complete your project in 25 days. So here you are crashing your network by 5 days na. Firstly, prior you are completing this project in 30 days, but now you have to complete this project in 25 days. So 5 days network crashing we have to do in this case. So by expediting your project, means if you are decreasing the time of your project, then ultimately directly or indirectly it affects the cost of your project, means the overall cost of the project now gets increased because you are decreasing your time. So you need extra resources. Resources in what sense? You need extra manpower, you need extra equipments, you need extra indirect cost. So the impact of all these costs leads to network crashing. So let us start with example. See in this slide, crashing. Project crashing is the method of shortening the project duration by reducing the time of one or more critical activities to less than their normal time. See, listen carefully. Here in network crashing, the importance is of critical activities only. You have to reduce the time of critical path only, because if you are not doing so, means if you are decreasing the time of non-critical activities, then the project overall project duration will not be changed. Because I have told you in unit second, that non-critical activities are having floats. Floats means extra number of days. So if you are decreasing the time of non-critical activities, then the impact in duration will not be changed. So if you have to change the time of overall project, then you have to strike to critical activities only. So here the act of adding more resources to expedite project activities is known as project crashing, and it is the method for shortening the project duration by reducing the time of one or more critical activities. Means you have to reduce the time of one or more critical activities only. Here we are not discussing about on non-critical activities. Just focus on critical activities and critical path only. So for crashing your network, you need to draw the network first and find out the critical path. Okay, so here see in this slide objective. What are our objective? To reduce the overall project duration and the while minimizing cost of crashing. So see, so we have different stages. Means in one project or in one network you can find various crashing stages. Means first stage crashing, second stage crashing, third stage crashing. So what are the meaning of these stages? So in all the stages you will calculate or you will come to know of project duration and the cost of project. So we'll compare the time, means duration and cost of all the stages. Then at last we'll finalize on which stage we have to carry our crashing of network. So let us start with example. See the question. Information about various activities of network shown in figure. I am explaining here basic question of network crashing. So it is the basic one and having two activities only. I'll also explain next numerical in which number of activities will be there. Okay, so just for your understanding I am explaining this basic question. So look at this page. The table is shown as below, that is activity. The table contains activity, normal duration, normal cost, crash duration and crash cost. So activity here is 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. Normal duration, that is the activity 1 to 2 is having 9 to 5. The activity 1 to 2 is having normal duration is of 9 days and 2 to 3 is of 5 days. So here 9 and 5 are the normal duration of an activity, of these two activities. Now see the third column, normal cost. So normal cost, which is in rupees, 1 to 2 activity, the completion of 1 to 2 activity cost rupees 8000 and 2 to 3 cost is 5000. See in next column, that is column number 4, crash duration. So crash duration here is for 1 to 2 activity 6 days are given in question and 2 to 3 for 3 days. So what does it mean here in crash duration? Crash duration means in place of 9 days you have to complete this activity in 6 days only. Okay, means you have to crash this activity by 3 days. See here. See, normal duration is this one 9 days. Okay, and crash duration becomes 6 days. Means you have to decrease the time of activity 1 to 2 by how much days? 3 days. So here 3 days crash you have to do. See the next one, that is 2 to 3 activity. Prior or normal duration of 2 to 3 is 5 days and here crash duration is 3 days. Means now you have to complete this activity in 3 days rather than 5 days. So these are the crash duration. Now this is crash cost. Crash cost means what is the meaning of crash cost and normal cost? Normal cost is different, crash cost is different. Normal cost means when the project is completing in normal duration. Crash cost means when the project is completing in crash duration. So normal cost for rupees for 1 to 2 activity is 8000 rupees. Now here 9500 only. Why? Because already I am telling you again and again, crash duration means if you are decreasing the time of your project, then ultimately it will leads to increase in the project overall cost. So obviously if you are completing your task prior to the expected time, then obviously it will cost more than expected because you need to indulge more resources in terms of manpower, machinery, equipments and all that things. So ultimately this will create this will create increment in cost. So here 2 to 3 activity prior the 5000 cost will be the normal, but here 5500 means 500 rupees here increases, and here in this activity how much? 1500 rupees. So here this is the crash cost. So I am telling you about explaining again about cost model diagram. See this one, this graph, cost versus time. I have explained you in lecture 2 or lecture 3, this the normal cost versus crash cost, or normal time versus crash time. So here this is cost and this is time. Okay, so this is normal cost. Suppose normal cost of a project is 700, okay, and here normal time is this one, 9 days. Okay, now you have to complete the project in this 6 days, means you are crashing your project by 3 days. Okay, so by crashing the project to some days, you need extra money, extra efforts, extra resources. So here by crashing this in 6 days, now cost it becomes 900, means cost becomes high than normal. Here 700, now the cost becomes 900, and prior the normal time is 9 days, now it's 6 days. So this is the crash time cost, or you can say cost time slope of a network, or cost time trade-off. So this I have already explained in detail in lecture 2. So you can refer from that lecture obviously. Now again see the question. The project overhead cost are rupees 300 per day. Overhead cost means what? Overhead cost means indirect cost. Indirect cost I have explained you in lecture 2 or lecture 3. So you can refer from that. So the project overhead cost are rupees 300 per day. So here determine direct cost duration relationship, and B is total cost duration relationship, and the corresponding least cost plan network. And the network is already given here. This is network having two activities, this one and this one. So two activities are total activities 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. Two activities are there in project. Okay. So 1 to 2 having 9 days is the normal duration and 6 days is the crash duration. Here 5th day normal and 3 is the crash duration. So these all things I have given in question. Now come to our solution first. So solution for the solution, step 1 is to find cost slope. Okay, so for this you need to learn about cost slope. What is the meaning of cost slope? So I have already discussed cost slope is the slope of direct cost. Okay, means it represent the increase in direct cost per unit decrease in activity duration, means it directly relates with activity duration. So in order to find the minimum project cost and the corresponding optimum duration, crashing of the network will be like that. So for that you need to find the first step is to find normal completion duration of the project and its critical path, as we have already done. And you all know about this, how will you construct the network diagram and how you have to calculate CPM, critical path. Okay, so first step is to find the normal duration of a project and CP and critical path. The second step is to find the cost slope of all the activities. Okay, now here two activities are there, so you need to find the cost slope of these two activities 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. Okay, then after that start crashing the network along the critical path. Okay, starting with the activity having minimum cost slope, this I'll discuss later. So let us, next step is cost slope. See, the cost slope for each activity will be as under. See table activity, del C represent increase in cost, del T represent decrease in time. See, you are decreasing your time by increasing the cost of activity. So here cost slope, what is cost slope? Cost slope is the relationship between del C and del T. So del C divided by del T is the cost slope of all the activities, means increase in direct cost per unit decrease in time. Del C means increase in cost and del T means decrease in time. So the increase in direct cost per unit decrease in time. So here you have to write all the activities. In our question we have two activities, 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. So del C is the increase in cost. So increase in cost how much? Prior normal duration, normal cost of 1 to 2 activities how much? Normal cost is 1 to 2 activity 8000 and crash cost is 9500. So increase in cost is 1500. See here, for 2 to 3 activity normal cost is 5000, crash cost is 5500. So here del C is 500. Now del T. Del T means now time decrement. Okay, cost will increase and time will decrease. Okay, so see here del T. So normal time for normal duration for activity 1 to 2 is 9 days and for crash duration 6 days. So overall del T is change in time is 9 minus 6, 3 days. Okay, and for 2 to 3 activity normal duration is 5 days and crash duration is 3 days. So 5 minus 3 will be 2. So here this is 2. Now calculate cost law by this formula del C by del T. So the cost law for activity 1 to 2 is 500 and 2 to 3 is 200. See, this is for activity 1 to 2 500 per day rupees. Okay, this is the increment in per day rupees. Okay, now step 2, let us come to step 2, that is normal distribution direct cost. See here, the normal duration for the project is, now the normal duration of the project becomes 9, for the normal duration is for first activity 9 and 9 plus 5, 14 days. This is the normal duration. Now normal duration cost, what is means, this is, these are the normal duration and normal cost as per your network diagram without crashing. So 8000 plus 13000. So this is the normal duration, step 2. Now step 3 is you have to crash the activity of critical path. So here in our question we have two activities only, means 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. So 1 to 3 is the critical path, though because we don't have any other path. So 1 to 3 is the critical path only. So 1 to 3 contains two path, that is 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. So let us start with 2 to 3 first, because we have to start with from which activity you have to crash your network. You have to start the network along the critical path having minimum cost slope. So means the cost slope, for which activity the cost slope is minimum, you have to start from that activity only. So look at this, the cost slope for 1 to 2 is 500 and 2 to 3 is 250. So the minimum cost slope among these 2 3 is 2 to 3. So start with activity 2 to 3. So here we are crashing our activity 2 to 3. Crashing means you have to find the duration and cost. Again and again you have to find duration and cost. So duration by which activity 2 to 3 can be crashed, for how many days? 2 days. Prior the duration is 5, now 3 days. You have to complete this activity in 3 days and crash duration is 2 days. Means you are reducing the time of activity by 2 days. So extra cost of crashing is 2, extra cost of crashing is, see, here, see, just a minute, see, 250 for 1 day. Okay, and this activity is crashing by 2 days. So 2 days means 250 into 2, 500. Here 250 into 2, 500, means 500 is the extra cost of crashing of this activity 2 to 3, because you are crashing this activity by 2 days. So here cost of crashing, and now project duration becomes the first activity again 9 days because we have not crashed yet now, and the second activity becomes 3 days. Now earlier it was 5 days, now it becomes 3 days. So 9 plus 3 is 12 days, means the normal duration 14 days, now your project duration becomes 12 days. So direct cost for 12 days is, direct cost means, and the for the normal duration cost is 13000 your project. Now extra cost how much you have increased? extra cost is 500 and 13,000 is the normal. 13,000 plus 500, it becomes 13,500 cost. So now the direct cost of a project becomes 13,500. Earlier it was 13,000. Okay, so here we have crashed our activity number 1, that is 2 to 3, because 2 to 3 is having minimum cost slope. Now we'll crash the activity 2, that is 1 to 2. See, step 4, crashing of the activity 1 to 2. Now let us crash activity for how many days? The earlier the activity 1 to 2 was completing in 9 days. Now you have to complete this activity in 6 days. Means for how many days you are crashing? 9 minus 6, that is 3 days. So 3 days se aap crash kar rahe ho, it means 3 days ka extra cost jo bhi hoga wo aapko yahan par calculate karna hai. So listen here, extra cost of crashing is 3 into 500. Why 500? Because 500 is the cost slope of this activity. Means this activity is having 500 per day extra cost of crashing. So we are crashing here by 3 days. 3 into 500, 1500. So the project duration becomes 6 plus 3, that is 9 days. 6 because 6, 6, why? Earlier it was 9 days, now you have to complete this in 6 days, and the for second activity 3 days, already we have crashed. So the project overall duration becomes 9 days, and the direct cost for 9 days will be, earlier the cost will be 13,500, now you can add this 1500 extra to it. So now the total cost of your project becomes 15,000. So this is your project cost and project duration. We have only two activities in this question. So now we have completed our question fully. So the project duration and the overall cost of your project is, the duration is 9 days. Now project, earlier it was, the overall duration is 13 days. Now you have crashed this project by 9 days. Okay. And the cost of your project, earlier it was 13,000. Now the project cost becomes 15,000. See here, 15,000. So time, you have crashed your network by decreasing the time, and ultimately it will increase the overall cost of your project. Now let us draw the table first. See, crashed network. Now again you have to redraw your network by crashing it. Okay, so 6 and 6 here, 3 and 3. Okay, this is your crash, and total, now step 5 is the to find the total cost of the project. See, total cost means it includes direct cost as well as indirect cost. Already I have discussed you about this, ki what is indirect cost and what is direct cost. So I am explaining you again here. Indirect cost is the expenditure that is being incurred for different activities of the project, but it can be only assessed for the project as a whole, like administration charges, establishment charges, store charges, penalties, loss of revenue, supervision charges, overhead, loss or profit. So these are the indirect cost. Okay, overhead, supervisions and all. And direct cost means it is the expenditures that can be identified with the execution of different activities of the project. Like direct cost means what you are seeing in your project, like material cost, labor cost, equipment cost. So these are the direct cost. Okay, so these are the two different types of cost, indirect cost and direct cost. So by adding these two cost, you will get to know the total cost of your project. So see here, look, total cost of project. So right here, duration, so 14 days, this is the normal duration, 14 days, and first you crashed your project by 12 days, and finally you have crashed by 9 days. So direct cost for 14 days completion 13 days 13,000, 12 days 13,500, and for 9 days 15,000. So these are the direct cost. As in our question, it has given that the project overhead cost are rupees 300 per day. So what does it mean? It means this is the direct co indirect cost of a project, that is 300 per day. So indirect cost for 14 days, 300 into 14 becomes for 4200. 300 into 12 becomes 3600. 300 into 9 becomes 2700. So by adding these two, direct and indirect cost, you will get total cost of your project. So see here, total cost for 14 days 17200, for 12 days 17100, and for 17700. So these are the total cost of project and total cost of project and duration. So like this, you have to crash your network and you will get to know, the project manager will get to know how much it affects on cost, how much the cost of the project is increasing by crashing the network in your required time, for your required time. So like this, we have to crash the network again and again. So today's lecture, I think I'll stop this lecture at this point only. So tomorrow I'll continue the lecture with same topic, network crashing with different numerical. And the numerical, this is the, see, today I explained basic numerical, completely basic numerical, because this numerical contains two activities only. Tomorrow I'll explain the complete example having 4 to 5 activities, having network diagram as well, critical path as well. So we'll discuss that, and all of you listen tomorrow's lecture at any cost, because the tomorrow's example will be very important for exam point of view. Okay, thank you all of you.